Hi guys, welcome back. So, in last night's video, I said that I think right now the market is at the rebound trend towards making a new high before a bigger correction later. But at most, we can see some pullback before. We took a look at Apple yesterday. I said that it can come back to backtest the support of 123 to see if this support is strong enough to hold it. And if so, then Nasdaq would be pulling back and rebound as support. And today we saw that Apple exactly backtested the support of 123. But today's movement was not looking very good because it closed at 123. So it looks like it wants to reach lower lows. Tomorrow, if it open up low and get back up the support, let's say it get back above the support within 1 to 3 days, it's not considered breaking the support yet. But recently, Apple is in a downward trend overall. And same thing with Amazon. Last night, I said Amazon can backtest the 250 moving average like last time. Here and here and here. Multiple times it backtested that and rebound from there. Every time it spends 3 days near the support level before a rebound. So we'll see if this time it's the same. But other than that, Google and Facebook is still on an uptrend. So right now it's just backtesting. All the tech stocks gapped down below today. The movement did not look very good, so it looks like the market would either reach lower low or take a few days to consolidate. So that's why today we saw Nasdaq had a gap down. It went down quickly at some point, dropping to 1.5%, but also rebound fast at some point, form a double bottom. So this support was supposed to hold. It held a few times throughout the day, but until the closing, looks like it was breaking the support. But on the other hand, Dow Jones looked much better in the movement. In the morning, it also gapped down below, reaching as low as 0.75% down, but also had a very quick V-shape recovery. And the whole time was moving up and down, mostly flat. So there might be a possibility that the money that moved to a lot of tech stocks during this rebound is starting to move some back to Dow Jones. Like I said, the money has been moving very quickly. It's impossible to time the sector rotation. So either you are diversified in your portfolio or you just stay consistent and not moving around trying to follow the institutions. But by the time you realize it, they might have moved the money already somewhere else. So that's why I think the best thing to do is either you are diversified into different sectors or you are consistent. For us, we bought in recovery, like airline, like our Mesa, as a hedge, because airlines would follow Dow Jones more. So Nasdaq today got supported by the crossover of 20 and 60 moving average at 13,470, and today the lowest was 13,469. Let's see if this support can hold, and if it doesn't, it might backtest the support of 13,300, so another 1 or 2% from the lowest point today. So I don't see a lot of room to drop this time for the pullback, because I still see we are at the rebound trend to make another all-time high before a bigger correction next time. Because right now the fear and greed index shows neutral. After almost 2 weeks of uptrend, it's not even in the greed zone yet. So that's why I think there is still room. And also we should be happy about the dipping. The more the better. I have trimmed some long-term position. So if they dip back to be, let's say, more than 10% of my selling price, I'll be happy to buy them back. Because so far these days I've been doing some trading and just to aim for some quick profit with stop loss too. So the dipping of the market cannot get me trapped and I can always have the cash to buy the dip. Appears to be likely. What do you think will generally happen to our Chinese stocks? How much estimated downside do you see the Chinese stocks will have? Well, first of all, I think since the bottom on May 12th, we have had more than 2 weeks of uptrend overall. So it's completely normal to have some pullback. And right now we have only had 1 day of pulling back. So it's not enough to be afraid. Looking back, every time it pulled back was a good opportunity to buy the dip of your long-term position that you like. So I think the overall uptrend is still here, except that we need to tolerate the short-term volatility. Like I said yesterday, if you're worried, just set stop loss for the trades or investment that you are worried about and set up target to buy the dip for your long-term investment. And to answer the question about Chinese stocks, if there is financial crisis in the US stock market, like what happened last year in March or 2008, something like this, of course it would crash the whole world's financial market, because obviously the US is still the center of the financial market. But right now we are just having a little pullback. It's not systematic risk that much yet, at least. So the US stock market somehow would affect the Chinese market, of course. But sometimes they can also have some divergence. And Hong Kong's Hang Seng Index responds to both the US market and the Chinese Shanghai market. Maybe the Shanghai Composite Index more than the US. And our stocks, our Chinese stocks that are listed in the US stock market, does get affected on the US side and also the Chinese side. Let's say if the US stock market crash, then of course everything would crash. But right now, I don't think we need to be too fearful yet. I do see a bigger correction, but probably not right now. And let's look at the Shanghai Composite Index. So far, it had been doing consolidation for a few days, as you see, going on the side. And every day, we have had a long hammer line underneath, because every day there's basically a V-shaped recovery during the day. So far, for the past 5 to 7 trading days, it has been the same thing. Gap down below, V-shape up. Dive down in the middle and V-shape up. Open down and V-shape up. Again, V-shape recovery every day. And today, it gap down quite low and somehow can still V-shape up. Right now, it's up 0.14% at this time. So even though after the day when the whole US stock market were all down, all negative, all the index were down, the Shanghai Composite Index can still do the same V-shaped recovery like every day. I don't know how they do it. When it opened up, it gapped down below and quickly went down below as much as minus 0.62% and then quickly went back up to be positive. So yeah, like I said yesterday, it seems like they're doing a lot of shaking, a lot of wash sell without going down much further. It's like they refuse to go down. And because the Shanghai Composite Index went back up, the same thing happened with the Hang Seng Index. You see, it went down quickly to be minus 0.7% and went back up quite fast, a V-shaped recovery. But right now it does have resistance above at 29,200. So I don't think it's likely for it to get back up that quickly. So I do think it would take time to digest the selling pressure for now. Either have some pullback, dipping a little lower, or using more time to consolidate. But what might be more concerning is RK. RK is an indicator of a lot of growth stocks or smaller caps. As you see, the whole day, it did not follow the market to do a V-shaped recover, and then instead, it just went back up a little bit and every time making lower lows. Compared to Russell 2000, the indicator for smaller caps, it had a nice recover throughout the day and did not make lower lows. So it's the same thing. It seems like RK is getting a lot of short sellers' attention right now again. A lot of short positions have been opened today. Now it's back testing the important support of the 250-day moving average again. If RK is heavily shorted, that means the ARK-related stocks like the growth stocks, Tesla or Bitcoin, etc. might be having more attention by the shorts. But even though the market is generally down, most of the stocks were down. Today, our stocks were not down a lot like before. So far, a lot of them had reached the support I mentioned before. Yesterday, I emphasized again to not FOMO into anything, but instead we buy at the red, we buy the dip. And I said that it's Chinese stocks, then there is always drama or bad news that can drive them down, like companies blacklisting, the SEC, or the political issue, etc. That would drive them pull back. And right away today, we saw the news saying Biden expands Trump-era ban on investment in Chinese firms linked to military. Well, luckily that none of our stocks were included in the blacklist. The ban that was out today, the new order lists 59 Chinese firms, substantially expands an order issued in November by President Donald Trump. It is creating more fear because at first we all expected President Biden to remove the ban or blacklist towards Chinese companies, but instead he's expanding to more. I guess that's out of everybody's expectation, but it is what it is. We have went over with the effect on how his investment ban on Chinese firms would affect the Chinese companies we're investing in, and how it would affect the Chinese technology development. But the sure thing is, I don't see this kind of news stopping anytime. I think they're gonna be like this for a long time. And that is just the truth we have to accept if we want to invest in China. But if you are worried, you can check the videos I made before about this. In this video, I talked about how the US investment ban on Chinese companies would push more Chinese companies to get a secondary listing in Hong Kong market or Shanghai market. And because the overall trend of China investment is still going on, so instead of hurting the Chinese companies, it might end up to be a benefit for the Chinese financial market to attract more international capital inflowing out of the country. And so far, in the recent few weeks, we have seen a lot of money inflow to China and Hong Kong. I said this yesterday. And then in this video, I talked about whether I would think Biden's Buy American plan and the investment ban would destroy the Chinese technology development. So I said when bad news happen like this and drive the share price down, watch out whether it would break the support. If it just touch back test the support and not breaking it, then it might be a good chance to buy the dip. For example, for NIO, the support right now is the range of 38 to 40 and it hasn't broken the support yet. First support 38 to 40 and then 35 and 33. Although it might be hard for NIO to break so many supports now, unless it's really bad black swan news. EH is touching the support I drew before at 27. Last night I said LKCO support is at 1.36. Today it back tested 1.35. It was a really quick dip in the morning at 1.35, maybe just for a few seconds. Luckin did a V-shaped recovery today, something that looks quite interesting. Feels like it's up to something, but I kinda don't want it to go up yet. I hope it can dip lower for me to buy more. Well, TAL had a really strong dip again today. I think it was driven by the news that Goldman Sachs downgraded the stock of GoTo, another Chinese education company, from buy to neutral and lower the price target from 60 to 20. Well, that is a big downgrade, cutting the price target to just 1/3. And also a lot of short sellers are opening more position in TAL and EDU. For me, I bought in the dip again at 32 today. I have explained my reasoning in my video about TAL last Monday. I know right now it's full of uncertainties about Chinese education stocks at this moment because of the regulations. But in the long term, Chinese parents that want to spend effort in their kids' education, this is a trend that is very unlikely to change and is so deep inside the DNA, the culture. And also, right now the share price has dropped to back to 2017. So basically, if you bought in this 4 years ago and now you're back to ground zero. It has wiped off the effort of the company for 4 years. And I believe that during these 4 years, they have accumulated the customer base, the publicity, the brand awareness, the word of mouth, and their technology from offline to online education, the management has to have improved. So all of their efforts accumulated for over the past 4 years, I don't think it should be wiped off entirely within 2 months just because of the uncertainties about regulations, especially if something that's so deep inside the need for Chinese parents. Of course, it might take a big hit for all of the companies in the short term. But in the long run, I've given my reasoning in my last video, and TAL is the leader of the education sector, the most famous brand in China for education. So even though today when everything was down, our trades did not do so bad. CAN was up 8.7%. At some point, it rallied up to 14%. Another crazy day. SOS also, at some point, rallied up to 10% up. Got back down by the market. But after an hour, it continued growing. Yibang was not bad either. Xunlei would follow as well, I think. Another trade, the one I mentioned yesterday, TKAT. I bought it in the morning at 18.2. I think most of you in the Discord might get the price cheaper than mine, because later on it dropped to as low as 17.8 and suddenly jumped up to as high as 7%. So from minus 5% to increase of 7%. Very volatile, up and down 12%. I set automatic order to book profit at 18.8. But I think there is still chance if the market gets more stabilized. QS also had a great day at first. At some point, it was doing a V-shaped recovery from minus 4% to as high as plus 4%. So touched $30 and came back down. Right now, the strongest support is at 26.5. So as long as it doesn't break the support, we can still hold it to see if the market stabilizes. I think it can still run, but you can also book profit anytime. In the market like today, it's very hard to do a good trade. So don't be afraid to take profit or set the trailing stop limit to book profit. It's better to make less than losing. And when the market shows stability, you can always re-enter with less risk. My Discord member asked me today, what do I think of FireEye, F-E-Y-E, after announcing selling the product business to go down 17%. So FireEye, it went down 17% today. What a crazy dip. So the share price dropped because the company announced that they're selling the FireEye products business, including the name, to Symphony Technology Group in a $1.2 billion all-cash transaction. I was busy today and didn't have time to look too much into it, but from the look of it, I can give you my opinion. It seems like they want to separate FireEye's network email endpoint and cloud security products from their Mandiant's control software and service. It seems like they want to sell a part of the product so then they can refocus on what they think they're better at and also more demand, more potential for the future, which is their Mandiant solutions. This is the new software and service they have launched, and it seems like they, like the management, were quite confident about this new product, new solution they have created. They seem to be bullish on this, and I was also hoping for this to be their turning point as well. And why do they need to sell their product business? First of all, I don't think any company would sell their core business unless they don't think it fits their future strategy or their new business model anymore. And also, they might believe that someone else, another group, can take this and grow it further while they can focus on their core business. So I think it's not necessarily a bad thing, even though it means temporarily they might have less source of revenue. But at the same time, it could mean that they are confident that if they focus on the core business, they can get it growing faster. On top of that, they are selling the product for $1.2 billion, and that is cash for the company for future development, R&D, and so on. And today, the share price dropping 17%, actually just make the company reduce the value by around 1 billion. So the company valuation reduced 1 billion and they're getting 1.2 billion cash. And also they announced a 500 million share buyback program. So this seemed to me it might not be entirely a bad news, but the market sure did respond as a bad news. Very bad, in fact. You know, I bought in FireEye sometime in April. I don't remember the date exactly, but I have sold it recently after a good run up. On May 21st, I said I took profit from FireEye already. And then May 24th, I said I sold the call option as well. It was up 172%. But I still like very much the cybersecurity industry right now, especially at this moment when there is a lot of political attention in the world, a lot of hacking activities, US and China fighting for technology growth, and companies hacking each other, especially right now. There are a lot of working online, sharing files so easily, so things can easily leak or get unprotected. And also so much happening at the same time in the crypto world. People worry about the cryptocurrency broker get hacked and bitcoins get stolen and so on and so forth. So I think at this moment, cybersecurity, it would be more and more needed and the heated discussion later. So I think at this moment, it would be good timing to get in the cybersecurity. But at this point, it would be better to see the share price get stabilized and not continue dipping. Otherwise, there are also other companies that are good for cybersecurities as well. Now, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give me a big, big like and write me a great comment. And I'll see you tomorrow. That's it, guys. Hope you can find my videos helpful. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and give me a big like. Thank you.